Hi friends, this is a video lecture forum of Department of BCom Corporate Secretaryship of Sri Krishna Swami College for Women. This is Savitri, Assistant Professor of BCom CS, Sri Krishna Swami College for Women. Today, I am going to teach essential elements of a valid contract. According to Section 10 of Indian Contract Act 1872, all agreements or contracts, if they are made by the free consent of parties competent to contract for a lawful consideration and with a lawful object and are not expressly declared to be void. In this definition, they have mentioned six essential elements of a valid contract. First one is agreement. Second one is free consent of parties. Third, competent to contract. Fourth, lawful consideration. Fifth, lawful object. And sixth, agreement not expressly declared to be void. Apart from these six elements, there are two more elements. They are intention to create legal relationship and certainty and possibility of performance. Element 1, offer and acceptance. Every agreement must have offer and acceptance. So, two parties to an agreement are offerer and acceptor. Offerer is a person who is making offer, and the second party, acceptor, is a person who is accepting offer. Offer must be definite and acceptance must be absolute and unconditional. I will give you an example. Miss Ramya offers to sell her bicycle at Rs. 5000. This offer statement is very clear with the product and the price. Now, Miss Divya is accepting the offer without any bargaining or negotiation. So, acceptance must be unconditional and absolute. And also, Divya should communicate to the offerer Miss Ramya in a prescribed manner. Element 2. Intention to create legal relationship. A valid contract can be created when there is a legal relationship between offerer and acceptor. If the offerer and acceptor have no any legal relationship, then no valid contract will be created. If there is a social and domestic nature of relationship between offerer and acceptor, it is not termed as a legal relationship between them. Say for example, a father and son is not having legal relationship. They are only having social and domestic relationship. So, if your father used to pay rupees 50 every day as a pocket money to his son, if one day he fails to pay, not sure on father, because they are having only domestic relationship. Element 3. Lawful consideration. Agreement to be enforceable by law must have consideration. So we should know what is meant by consideration. Consideration means something in return. An advantage or benefit moving from one person to another person is called as consideration. Both parties give something and get something. In that first example, we have seen Ramya sells her bicycle to Miss Divya and Divya pays Rs. 5000 to Miss Ramya. So, both of them are getting something. If you promise to do something but getting nothing is not enforceable by law, then a contract will not be created. Consideration can be cash or kind or to do an act or abstinence. And also, consideration must be real and lawful. It can be at past, present and future. Element 4. Capacity of parties. Both the parties, offerer and acceptor, must be capable of entering into a valid contract. This is also known as competency of parties. When the parties are having the three conditions satisfied, age of majority, sound mind and not disqualified by any law, then they are having the eligibility to entering into a valid contract. If they are not having the eligibility, like age of minority, lunacy, idiocy, unsound mind, disqualified by any law, drunkenness, then there is a flaw in capacity So, the agreement cannot be enforceable by law and a valid contract cannot be created. Element 5. Free and genuine consent. It is an essential element to create a valid contract. In this element, we should also know consensus ad item, which means both the parties, offerer and acceptor, should have same mind on all material terms of the contract in the same sense at the same time. If there is no free and genuine consent, then no contract will be created. Absence of free consent of the parties induced by 5 ways. First one is coercion, which means threatening or physical compulsion. Second is undue influence, which means compelled against his will. Third one is fraud. This is called as intentional misrepresentation to deceive other party. Fourth one is misrepresentation. Misrepresentation is the innocent misrepresentation. There is no intention. Mistake, erroneous belief of something. Element 6. Lawful object. Object of the agreement must be lawful. Object is the main core element of the contract or agreement. Ramya, in the first example we have seen, Ramya sells her bicycle to Ms. Divya at rupees 5000. So selling bicycle is a legal, lawful object. If we will take another example, Mr. Ram sells drugs, prohibited goods to someone, it is an illegal, immoral and opposed to public policy terms. So if there is any law, any legal flaw, it would not be enforceable by law. Element 7. Agreement not declared void. Agreement equal to offer plus acceptance. Contract comes from the agreement enforceable by law. If agreement is void, then contract will also be void. So contract will not be created when agreement is void. Therefore, agreement must not have declared void to create a contract. 8th one is certainty and possibility of performance. An agreement should be certain and definite. Certain and definite in the sense, the agreement, the subject matter of the agreement should be possible to do the act. Agreement must not be vague or indefinite. We will take another example to explain this term vague, which means to lift Himalaya is impossible to everyone. To stop rain, it is also impossible to everyone. So these type of terms could not be encouraged in an agreement. If it is vague, it is not possible to ascertain its meaning, then the agreement cannot be enforced. Then the contract will not also be enforced. So finally, we came to the end. We have seen 8 elements. Now I will give you a term which is OILCFLAC. Comment if you find this term. Thank you.